2 of the ACC tourney begins with one of the ACC's best rivalries, NC State and North Carolina. These two teams have met 13 times in the tourney, with UNC holding a 7-6 advantage. Then in the second game of our day session, you'll see one of the best point guards in the country, Syracuse guard Tiana Mungakahia, who leads the nation in assists per game. Two great matchups, NC State, North Carolina, Syracuse, Virginia Tech. They're up next as the ACC tournament rolls along from Tournament Town, Greensboro, North Carolina. We welcome you inside the Greensboro Coliseum. We are moments away from game one of day two. The North Carolina Tar Heels and the number 23 team of the nation, the NC State Wolfpack from the Greensboro Coliseum. It is so great to have you with us for the ACC Women's Tournament, the 41st edition. I'm Tom Wormy. Three exciting games yesterday, three teams advancing to the second round. Today we've got four games for you, and we start it with North Carolina and NC State. Let's take a look at that championship bracket in this tournament and show you how these teams advanced. North Carolina to play the Wolfpack after it beat Boston College 69-64. Syracuse and Virginia Tech hit the court for the first time in the tournament and their first meeting in the tournament. Virginia and Georgia Tech after the Jackets beat Clemson in round one. Virginia's won three in a row in that series. In Miami and Wake Forest, the last game of the day, Wake Forest defeating Pittsburgh 72-38 to advance to play Miami, the number six seed. They've met twice in the tournament, and Wake has won both of those meetings. Well, the premier performance of day one had to be sophomore Paris Key in her hometown of Greensboro, North Carolina, for the Tar Heels. What a game for Key. She had 20 points in the first half to ensure victory, 28 overall against Boston College. Key on the steal and the drive, and she had four three-pointers as well, and she played every second of the game to beat BC 69-64 to advance to take on NC State. So with the call of game one, let's go down to Jen Hildreth and LaChana Robinson.
Tom, Paris Key said after the game yesterday, it was a dream come true. Having that type of performance, her team getting the win here in Greensboro. LaChina, can she do it again? Does she need to do it again for her team to keep winning?
Well, it's going to take a lot of Paris Key and a lot of offense from North Carolina because this NC State defense is stout. But the good sign for the Tar Heels is they got balanced contributions down the stretch. Jalen Murray had some good moments. Taylor Coonan, and of course, the ACC Freshman of the Year, Janelle Bailey, really came on strong in the second half in that win over Boston College.
Well, North Carolina is going to have to find something that gets working because NC State has had their number, LaChina. The Wolfpack swept the regular season series, have won five of the last six against North Carolina. And boy, did they finish this season strong after being picked to finish 10th in the conference. They were tied for fourth, won 10 of their last 12.
Westmore's team knows what they do well, and they've done it consistently. They are a great rebounding team. They are a great defensive team as well. They are anchored in the post by Chelsea Nelson and also Akila Mays. They have rode those two down low and have been successful all season.
Tremendous job by Westmore as we take a look at our starting lineup. Brought to you by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. Jamie Cherry, Taylor Coonan, Paris Key, Jalen Murray, Janelle Bailey for the Tar Heels. Ace Lynn Kodig, Kayla Ely, Kiara Leslie, Chelsea Nelson, and Akila Mays for NC State. That's your starting lineup brought to you by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. Always entertaining anytime these two teams face off. A little crosstown rivalry between the Tar Heels and the Wolfpack. Tom mentioned their meetings in the ACC tournament. This is their 14th. They haven't met since a 2007 championship game, which North Carolina won 60-54. In fact, North Carolina has won the last six meetings in the ACC tournament. Quick foul picked up there by Chelsea Nelson, NC State's all-ACC first-team selection. Let's keep an eye on Jamie Cherry, too, for North Carolina. Remember, we saw her injured at the end of the first game, and that's how the first game started for Paris Key. I think it was the same spot, LaChina.
Yeah, I mean, Paris Key is playing with a tremendous amount of confidence. Now, this is a great defensive team for NC State. They've got their work cut out guarding 22 in blue.
Nelson trying to drive, kicks it out to Ely. The battle on the boards, it has been dominated by the Wolfpack
that
in this series.
Going to be the biggest factor, Jen, in this game is who wins the battle on the glass. North Carolina did out-rebound Boston College after a strong second half, but they haven't seen anything like NC State on the boards.
I mean, look at this possession. Mays claiming she was fouled.
The NC State starting out with Kira Leslie on key. They're going to put some size on her. She draws the foul there, but Paris Key put NC State on notice. The first possession, if you don't get out on her, she can stroke the three. She's doing it with consistency right now. She just lines it up. You got to be there.
And that last drive to the basket by Key was the second personal foul against Chelsea Nelson here in just the first minute and a half.
And that is not a good sign for Westmore's team. As we talked about in the open, Chelsea Nelson is the anchor. She is their calming factor. And they will miss her on the floor. We'll keep an eye on how long West can go without her.
Leading scorer, leading rebounder, forced to the bench early. And Paris Key looks like she is just going to keep this dream alive. Wolfpack trying to get it inside. Akila Mays passes it back out for Ely. This time she hits for three.
Really good ball movement for NC State inside out. And when Ely is knocking down outside shots, that helps them to open up that interior game. That's really what they want to go to, is inside to get high percentage looks.
Tar Heels get it back to Key. 10 on the shot clock. Three defenders around her. She stops, pulls up.
That was a heat check right there, Jim.
Key has all six of North Carolina's points.
Paris Key is sending a notice against NC State's man-to-man. A nice screen set. That's enough space for her to get that shot off. And a good ball movement by State. Goes inside. Mays has some congestion defensively, but finds the open shooter. And with Chelsea Nelson on the bench, it's going to take more offense, more players getting involved on that end for the Wolfpack to put points on the board.
ACC Rookie of the Year, Janelle Bailey, gets it back out to Cherry, just inside that three-point line. Rebound goes to Erica Cassell, the sophomore who came in for Nelson. Kunin with the board for the Tar Heels.
I also believe that pace is important in this game. NC State wants to play a slower game. They can play in transition, but they can't put a lot of points on the board. North Carolina has more potential from the scoring standpoint. And so NC State has to limit the possessions.
This was the injury we were talking about at the end of the Boston College game yesterday. Jamie Cherry. Everybody a bit concerned when we saw that happen.
Yeah, it looks like just that right foot area. We've been told that she was receiving treatment for the Achilles area on that foot all evening with the training staff for North Carolina, getting rest, so we'll have to keep our eyes on that.
Just 7 points, but 8 assists for Cherry, who did play all 40 minutes in that first game yesterday. And coming into this year's ACC tournament, she's been one of the best for the Tar Heels, averages 18 points per game in the ACC tournament in her career. Good effort on the defensive end that time from Cherry and the Tar Heels. First turnover.
Some emotion from Jamie Cherry, which has not always been the case for the senior. A good read there. Good job getting in the passing lane. She's trying to get her team fired up early.
Only senior on this North Carolina team. Paris Key, that's her spot. Oh, my. As Tom Murray said, the signature performance from day one, 9 points already for Paris Key. We're not even halfway through the first quarter. Aislinn Koenig for NC State. One of our best three-point shooters doesn't hit.
Last few possessions, North Carolina limiting NC State to only one look.
Jalen Murray, first shot is missed. Cassell with the board. NC State just 1 of 8 to start this game.
And they're out of flow on the offensive end.
That will be a blocking foul against Paris Key.
Yeah, NC State is, I mean, they put points on the board, but not a lot of flow for them on that end of the floor. Leslie on the drive here. And the basket is good. And if you're trying to slow down Paris Key, that may be the best strategy. Get her in some foul trouble and get her to start thinking about putting the ball on the deck in other situations.
And I think depth-wise, LaChina, you would certainly give the advantage to NC State in this matchup. North Carolina so heavily reliant upon their starting five, four of them averaging over 30 minutes per game. As Bailey has it blocked by Mays. The senior relished that one a little bit. Cassell working on Bailey, had it blocked, still trying, and then is fouled. That's the first against Janelle Bailey. Cassell on the free throw line. Chelsea Shine reporting for us all tournament long. Chelsea, what can you tell us about the Wolfpack when they get here to the free throw line?
Yeah, well, guys, North Carolina State has been really good from the free throw line. Ninth in the nation in free throw attempts with 638. As a team, they average 22 free throw attempts per game. And so this is a team that's aggressive to the basket and gets a lot of points at the line. And I think that'll be something to keep an eye on for today.
That is something that I think people don't pay enough attention to. Chelsea, that is a great point, because not only do you get to the free throw line and get free opportunities, but you're getting the other team's players in foul trouble.
Right.
And just setting a precedence that you're going to be physical. And that's what they've been this year. That's how they dominated the glass. They've just been tough.
Paris Key was receiving a little bit of treatment, you may have seen there. Had some blood on her lip. I have a feeling that's not going to slow her down at all.
Well, you see Leslie has now extended that defense and got a hand in Key's face.
Contested shot that time from Key. Bailey down on the ground. Mays takes advantage.
Now, we talk about Paris Key being a Greensboro native. Akilah Mays is also. She said she remembers those battles in high school with Paris Key.
7-0 run by the Wolfpack. Make this a one-point game. Bailey grabbed the rebound and was fouled. But a heat check needed, LaChina, as Paris Key starting out on fire.
Fans, grab your popcorn. Do you love it? The play of Paris Key has been outstanding early. The Greensboro native is home.
It is a one-point game in Greensboro, and one of the storylines in this game may be Chelsea Nelson, who went to the bench early with foul trouble. For more on that, let's go to our Chelsea Shine.
Thanks, Jen. Yeah, absolutely something to keep an eye on during this game. Chelsea Nelson, the leader inside for the post for NC State, has been in foul trouble a lot this season. That's been an issue. 6 times she's fouled out of games. 2 of those games in conference play against Virginia and Miami. NC State lost both of those games. She's had to be on the bench. Something Coach Moore said he really was hoping she would do a better job of this season is limiting the foul trouble. We're going to see a lot more minutes coming from sophomore forward Erica Cassell. Perhaps her best game of the season coming at Miami. She played 25 minutes, had 11 points, 11 rebounds. That was a game Chelsea Nelson fouled out of. She'll have to have a big afternoon here to sort of pick up where Chelsea Nelson's left off.
That's a great point, Chelsea, and we'll see how the Wolfpack fares without her. They have fought their way back to make this a one-point game. As the Tar Heels have cooled off a little bit, started 3 for 5, 0 of 6 cents, and there's a basket from Leslie. 5 points in the game for Leslie.
Mays and Leslie are really good at getting back in fast break situations for easy baskets. Now, North Carolina's playing on a back-to-back. Shouldn't be worried about legs this early in the game, but they have to make sure that they are energized and ready to get back.
You see Bailey hitting the shot from outside. That was a big adjustment in her game, wasn't it, LaChina? You picked up on in the second half yesterday.
Yeah, first to second half against Boston College. First half, they're double and triple teaming her. Second half, she steps out and shows that face-up game, and that was huge for North Carolina.
Leslie can't get the three, but the rebound to Cassell. Chelsea Shine just told you Erica Cassell is going to have to play some big minutes with Chelsea Nelson on the bench.
And it's those kind of little plays. Like, no one's asking her to go out and beat Chelsea Nelson or score 20 points a game, but can you get an extra possession for your team? Can you get a tip or deflection that stops a possession for North Carolina? Do some little things in this first half until Nelson's able to get back in.
Make your free throws. That's always a good thing. She's 3 for 3 so far, as you see Jocelyn Jones, a redshirt freshman for the Tar Heels, giving Jalen Murray a break. Four for four from the line is Cassell, and NC State takes the lead.
We have been able to slow Key down in the last at least couple of minutes of this game.
Bailey, too strong that time. Mays skying for the rebound. Leslie running the floor and getting rewarded.
If there was one area post-game yesterday that North Carolina said we've got to be better, it's in our transition defense. Boston College got some open threes, and now NC State's getting easy ones in transition.
And let's be honest, this North Carolina team, the knock on them, part of the reason they had a 9-game losing streak coming into the tournament, is on the defensive end of the floor. Their offense can typically keep up with just about anybody when they're making shots. What are they going to do on this end? As Koenig gets her first points of the game. Biggest lead of the game for NC State is the Tar Heels, just one of their last 10 from the floor. Koenig. Drought continues.
Sylvia Hatchell said she wanted her team to move the ball around and make NC State's defense work if they don't have anything in transition. And they've been taking some early shots the last few possessions.
Timeout, it looks like. Sylvia Hatchell wanted to talk to her team. Got a win on her 66th birthday yesterday, but her Tar Heels have gone cold from the floor here in the first quarter. Second day of the ACC tournament. NC State out in front. A 15-2 run has the NC State Wolfpack ahead of the Tar Heels by 5. Sylvia Hatchell not happy.
You know anything about these Tar Heels, their competitiveness comes from Sylvia Hatchell. She hates to lose more than she loves to win. And she understands she's got a young team, but she also knows she's got a talented team. And they're trying to ride that momentum of yesterday's win after a 9-game losing streak to end the season.
8 on the shot clock as Cherry backs up, plans her attack. She'll take it herself, had it blocked out of bounds. North Carolina basketball, just 3 on the shot clock.
North Carolina's got to be willing to work for offensive opportunities. Cut hard, set screens, work deep in the clock.
And Paris Key did not get that shot off in time. Turnover Tar Heels.
But at least it allows North Carolina to go back and get their defense set. We saw a lot of transition scoring for NC State, so let's see if the Tar Heels can get a stop here. North Carolina in a zone. We're expecting to see them change defenses quite a bit. Going back and forth from their switching man to their zone.
Koenig committing her first personal foul. Puts Jamie Cherry on the free throw line. She's already 2 for 2 in this game. Leads the team just under 84% from the line on the season.
Sorry.
We'll blame you for it. It's no problem.
Second one makes it a four-point lead now for NC State.
North Carolina picking up defensively here, trying to get some energy on that end of the floor.
Looked like North Carolina was starting strong in this one, but have tapered off, and slow starts have been a theme of the series against the Wolfpack this season as Koenig continues NC State's hot run.
Aislinn Koenig is showing us more facets of her game as this season has progressed, not just a three-point shooter.
Key gets it into Bailey. Got some contact and the finish.
Now with Chelsea Nelson on the bench, I'm surprised that North Carolina has not looked to go to Bailey more. Even if she's playing against Mays, you still are down a starting defender.
Cassell will get the ball. Off the glass and in. Good first quarter for Erica Cassell. 6 points in the game. That was her first field goal. And the NC State Wolfpack will have the advantage after quarter number one. Our score, 22-16 after a hot start from North Carolina. NC State finished strong. They'll have the advantage as we get set for quarter number two in Greensboro. Quarter number one in the books. Of day two of the ACC Women's Basketball Tournament. Take a look at our Hardys game summary. NC State really finishing that first quarter strong at 7 of their last 10 field goals, and quite the opposite story for North Carolina.
Yeah, when you look at NC State's 10 points in the paint, there were a couple that were traditional in their half court, but a lot of those were transition. And I think that's the biggest concern for North Carolina is getting back on the other end when they're not scoring, sprinting back and taking away the easy looks.
Tar Heels going into Bailey, something you thought we would see more of. It was Mays, though, providing some good defense, and Dee Dee Rogers coming over to provide some help to defense. And Jalen Murray, North Carolina, picks up her second personal foul. Chelsea Nelson still on the bench for NC State. Just 1 minute played in this game as she picked up her second personal foul with 8:38 on the clock in the first quarter. Six on the shot clock. Mays will take the short jumper and is fouled. Second on Bailey. Chelsea Shine told you earlier what a weapon free throws have been for this NC State team this season, and you can see that they have made more.
Or, you know, you go from last year where you had a dominant backcourt, and that was what your offense ran through, till this year trying to run it through the post. He said, you know, I didn't spend a ton of time figuring out how we would make that transition offensively, but he focused on the defense and rebounding, and that has paid off. And so getting to the free throw line has been a way for them to score the ball and not have to really stress about their half-court offense as much.
NC State team comes into the tournament, got a first-round bye, has won 10 of their last 12 games. They moved into the top 25 the last 4 weeks. Beat the Tar Heels by double digits in both of their meetings this season. So let's say hello to Leah Church. Good. The freshman hitting the three.
Patience. Good patience for North Carolina on the offensive end.
Koenig with the answer for the Wolfpack. A patient three and a quick three on the other end.
You have to know where Church is at all times, because she will make you pay for losing her behind the arc.
He looking for the backdoor pass to Cherry. Healy running the floor and gets it over Murray for the basket. 5 points in the game for Kayla Healy. This game back and forth. Cherry misses again. Everybody can catch their breath for a moment. Koenig looking to go right back to Mays. What a roll off that screen.
NC State finding some offense right here. Aislinn Koenig, her ability to create her own shot off of the bounce, impressive there. And then lack of transition defense for North Carolina. You have to know where the ball is, get back, get set, try to take a charge. But no communication in that situation, and it hurts you.
Mays on the free throw line, as you just saw. Jalen Murray picked up her third personal foul. Freshman has started all but two games this season for the Tar Heels.
And Jen, you mentioned early the lack of depth for North Carolina. Sylvia Hatcher, young team, has some injuries they worked through this year. We'll see how they handle that. Murray's still in the game right now.
Lead now 10 for NC State, their largest of the game, as Paris Key has an opportunity for the three-point play.
Well, NC State did a really good job for a stretch of containing Paris Key. But she just has the ability to make tough shots. That's not an easy shot. You're not upset with your defense there. You got there, you contested. She got it up and in. High level of difficulty.
Well, every one of Paris Key's baskets has resulted in 3 points in one way or another. Three the traditional way. That one, the old-fashioned way, to end one of the free throw. 12 points in the game for Key. Couple of steps as Leslie turns it over.
I think that might have been some junk defense there from North Carolina. Maybe a triangle and two, trying to mix it up a little bit.
Don't fall asleep over there, Chelsea Nelson. The team may need you here before too long. Leading scorer and rebounder for the Wolfpack. Getting a break she would hope not to have had to take due to early foul trouble. Key pulls up and hits it. 14 now for Paris Key, who had 20 in the first half yesterday against Boston College. Pulled the Tar Heels within five. Gambled a little on the defensive end as the Tar Heels scrambled to recover.
Paris Key on the offensive end a moment ago. She comes off the screen just hoping to get some space. The high hedge by Rogers, but it's the step back. I mean, creating space. Post screen and roll. That doesn't work out. Well, let me put the defense through this. And good job here by Leslie.
Had just enough defensive presence and pressure from Key to affect her shot. Does not get the two in transition. Can North Carolina take advantage now? Key step back, but not really of her own choice that time. Got knocked back a little bit.
She forced that one. Her team has to keep moving, even when she has the ball. But good job by Leslie shooting the gap. She knows that North Carolina wants to get the ball to Key, but she recovers all ball.
Easy Rogers out to Koenig. Leslie. Her shot kept alive from Rogers, who says hello to some of the fans courtside.
And that is a big call.
Fourth personal on Murray. And we're not even to halftime.
The officials determined that Rogers had possession there at the end. was a 50-50 ball for a majority of that scrap. But they decided she had gotten possession in time before the contact was made and called it on Murray.
So Jalen Murray with four fouls, no points in this game, but has been a consistent member of that starting lineup. See how long Sylvia Hatchell has to keep her on the bench. Key saw an opening. Couldn't get the roll that time, as Leslie is an excellent rebounder as well. Gets it for the Wolfpack. Rogers working against Key, has the size advantage.
Lee Rogers just plays so hard. Always going to the glass. Gives maximum defensive effort off of the bench.
She is such an important part of that bench as Bailey hits on the other end. It's hard to miss the extra effort you just mentioned you always see from Dee Dee Rogers. Of course, that Rogers name familiar to those in the ACC. Her sister Rodrika played at Georgia Tech. Her dad Rodney played at Wake Forest and then in the NBA. From the corner, the shot is short from Ely.
Carolina mixing up their defenses and NC State biting on taking the three.
Cherry trying to get to the basket. She is fouled. So Jamie Cherry trying to make things happen for the Tar Heels, who still trail NC State by five. Sylvia Hatchell's Tar Heels trailing NC State by five. And throughout her career, Coach Hatchell, I believe she talked to you about this earlier today, LaChina, she pointed out that a lot of her signature wins on her way to over 1,000 now have come against NC State. You tend to remember those no matter what, but especially when they come against one of your rivals.
Yeah, Sylvia Hatchell's always one to reflect on her friend, the late, great Kay Yao. And obviously a lot of those wins were against Kay, and she said, you know, they would just laugh about it after a while that those big wins were all coming against State. But she said she remembered one time in particular they played, NC State played North Carolina in the ACC tournament. It was in 2007, and NC State actually upset number one Duke in the semifinals, and Duke and Carolina met in the finals. But she just said it was magical for NC State, obviously, to get there for Coach Yao. And then North Carolina went to work. So,
and North Carolina now trying to avoid losing to NC State for three times in the season, same season, something that hasn't happened since 1989-90. It's not an easy thing to do.
At all.
And by the way, that season is the last time that NC State beat North Carolina in the ACC tournament.
Look at you with all the...
Oh, you know that's a team
next
effort.
Next level stats.
It's a team effort from our great crew here in Greensboro.
I don't know. These notes. You got notes on notes over here, Jen.
I just steal from all the smart people that we work with. Giselle picking up her first personal. How about Jamie Cherry, that last trip to the free throw line, missing them both.
Yeah, you wonder, just being a senior, being the only senior in this situation and having high expectations. I mean, she has performed well in the ACC tournament. She obviously wants to extend her career. We saw her go down at the end of yesterday's game. So a lot of things in at play here for Cherry.
She gets it out to Coonan for an open look. Bailey just held her ground, but then so did Mays. Took it right away from the freshman. Imani Hawkins into the game for NC State, number 50, as the ball goes back to Mays. Nice move! 6 in the game for the senior from right here in Greensboro, North Carolina.
Much improved. I mean, the strides she has made coming into this season are tremendous. Akilah Mays, one of the best defenders in the ACC on the all-defensive team. And then the effort to get back on the other end and scores in the low block. Just a pro move. And speaking of pro, she said she worked with NC State great Chastity Melvin over the summer. and that Chastity gave her lots of advice on how she could be more effective and said that's really what gave her a boost coming into this game.
Well,
excuse me, coming into the season.
Yeah, well, we've been talking about Akilah Mays and for good reason. Westmore just picked up a technical. So that puts Cherry back on the free throw line. She doesn't miss the first.
Well, there was a possession on that end of the floor when Mays got that block. And Wes, his assistant, had to come out and gather him. So the officials had obviously had enough there.
Well, sometimes those technical fouls have a way of firing up your team. Koenig answers with a three.
On cue.
North Carolina trying to find a way to regain some of that momentum that they had early when Paris Key was dropping threes. The long arms of Kiera Leslie facing up against Key is Cherry. Can't hit her shot. It has been a struggle offensively for Jamie Cherry in this ACC tournament so far. Certainly we'll give her credit for the 8 assists she had yesterday, but in terms of finding her own points, just haven't seen that from the senior. Key. Oh yeah, that's enough of an opening for Paris.
Well, and the aggressive mindset of Taylor Coonan is what set up that shot for Key.
17 points for Paris Key. 4 of those coming from downtown, 4 shots, that is, that she has made from 3.
I'm going to suggest you don't help off of Paris Key, but that's what Leslie does, and Paris Key makes her pay.
Doesn't need much of a window, does she? Hawkins takes it, hits it. Her first points of the game for the transfer out of Arizona State. Coonan gets it to Emily Sullivan, who just came into the game. Sophomore doesn't score much, but she scored a big one there.
Well, you be ready, Emily, for your time to shine.
That's what they always tell you when you're sitting on the bench. You never know when your number might be called. Mays driving to the basket. Uses that long reach just to go up and over the 6'4 Sullivan.
Oh, boy. That was strong. That was a dominant move by Mays.
Couple of kicks from Greensboro. Feeling it with Key on this end, maybe forcing it a bit.
Yeah, definitely.
Under a minute to play in the first half. Leslie's shot, no good, but Mays is there. 10 points now for Akilah Mays to go along with 6 rebounds. Paris Key called it a dream come true, said Greensboro had her back. Greensboro may have Mays' back, too.
And Akilah Mays has done a lot of this damage with Janelle Bailey on the bench.
Cherry to Sullivan. Cassell kept those arms up, did her job. It'll be North Carolina ball, 4 seconds on the shot clock. Be a foul called before the ball is inbounded. You saw Paris Key tumble to the ground. Here, Leslie whistled for the foul, her second. So Key will go to the free throw line, her team in the bonus. And she's pretty good from the stripe as well. 75% on the season, 18 points in the game now.
But credit Kiera Leslie, these points have not come easy. After those first few open threes, Leslie's made Key have to work, which may not pay off as much right now as it will maybe in the fourth quarter from her being tired, having to work and cut harder on screens. And that kind of thing.
Well, the little time-saving measure nearly hurting the Wolfpack. Hardik finally gets it. Tonkin shoots it, and a lot of contact. Going to go against the Wolfpack. It's going to put North Carolina back on the free throw line. Coming up on the Hardys Halftime Report, Tom Wormy will be joined by Senior Associate Commissioner of Women's Basketball for the ACC, Norlin Finch. He'll talk about this year's tournament as well as the great season all these ACC teams have had as they look toward the NCAA tournament. Plus, we will break down our first half between North Carolina and NC State.
I don't think there's anyone in the building happier than Norlin. I've run into her a couple times, and boy, she just is... She's happy to be back in Greensboro.
She is in her element, just does a tremendous job as the caretaker, if you will, women's basketball in this conference. Koenig, take it from just inside half court. Doesn't hit that one, but NC State with 43 points in the first half. Paris Key had 20 in the first half yesterday, 21 in the first half today to lead her Tar Heels, but they do trail their rivals from Raleigh. NC State won both of the regular season meetings against the Tar Heels, trying to make it three in a row. And now Chelsea is standing by with NC State head coach Wes Moore.
Coach, two quick fouls by Chelsea Nelson. I know that's the last thing you wanted to see, but big minutes by Erica Cassell and Akila Mays. How important were they?
They're big. I mean, again, I don't know how to explain it. We got a lot of fouls called on us. So, again, we just got to settle down, I guess, and try to keep our hands to ourselves. But it's very frustrating to have all-conference player go out 1.5 minutes into the game. So.
You guys really limited Carolina's offense other than Paris Key. What will be the biggest adjustments on her in the second half?
I don't know. We tried trapping her a little bit. She's good. Great player. We just got to keep getting up on her, put pressure on her, and then provide that person some help because she is going to go by you if you get up in her.
Great. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, Chelsea. Great to hear from Coach Moore. His team in the lead. Mind of the Hardys halftime report. Coming up, Tom Wormy and Norlin Finch, our special guest, coming your way at halftime as NC State leads North Carolina.
This is the Hardys Halftime Report from the ACC Women's Tournament, Greensboro, North Carolina, and the Greensboro Coliseum. Halftime of our first game, the Wolfpack leading the Tar Heels by 6. What a first half, though, by Paris Key. 4 made threes on 5 attempts and 21 points after she scored 20 yesterday in their win against Boston College in the first half. So glad to have you with us for the ACC Women's Tournament halftime of Game 1, Day 2. I'm Tom Wormy. A very special guest joining us from the platform high above the court here at the Greensboro Coliseum, and that is Norlin Finch, the Senior Associate Commissioner for Women's Basketball in the Atlantic Coast Conference. And Norlin, right off the top, a return to Greensboro, the 18th time we've been here. This is such a wonderful setting for this ACC tournament.
It is, Tom, and we feel like we've come home. I really want to thank Coastal Carolina and Myrtle Beach for the great hospitality last year. And, you know, it was pretty good seeing the ocean every day. But when you talk about women's basketball and the premier women's basketball championship tournament in the nation, you think Greensboro, North Carolina. And we are so glad to be back. This is our 18th year. And this is home. It's a fantastic building. It's a place that the community truly supports the event. And today we're having school day games with elementary school kids. And you talk about an electric environment. Put NC State, North Carolina in the same game in anything. And then you put screaming children in Greensboro. It just doesn't get better.
Yeah, what a great way to start our day. Can you believe this is the 41st all-time ACC Women's Tournament? And how about the strength of this conference, top to bottom, with so many teams contending for this title?
Tom, I think this is our strongest ever conference, top to bottom. When you look at the wins that we have on the national scale against the nation's best teams, you see, it's really important to play good teams. So that strength of schedule is SOS on the screen. That isn't save our souls. That is strength of schedule, and this conference has made a concerted effort to improve its non-conference schedule, and we have fared well. We are the number one conference in the rating percentage index, the strength of schedule against non-conference opponents, the strength of schedule overall when you put the conference games in. We have seven teams with 20 wins, and Virginia at 17 wins has played the number three most difficult schedule in the country. Quality, really good, and quantity. Eight good teams that I think should be in the NCAA tournament.
I know you crunched the numbers because you showed me all the math that you scribbled out.
And the numbers prove it, right. Tom. The numbers exactly. Prove it, folks.
Exactly. Nora Lynn is going to stick around for one more segment with us, and we're going to talk about who might challenge the four-time defending champs at the ACC tournament, the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, the number two seed. Louisville's the number one seed. We'll talk more with Nora Lynn in just a moment on the Hardee's Halftime Report. Back on the Hardee's Halftime Report, the Wolfpack with a six-point lead against the Tar Heels. Halftime of Game 1. We've been joined by Nora Lynn Finch, the Senior Associate Commissioner of Women's Basketball in the ACC. And Nora Lynn, we were talking about what team you think might be able to challenge Notre Dame. Well, the first team that comes to mind has got to be the number one seed in our tournament, the Louisville Cardinals.
Gosh, you're smart, Tom, because Louisville is the team that has beaten Notre Dame. And Notre Dame has gone through the ACC in its first 4 years without, you know, much of a hiccup. They lost NC State last season, but it's Louisville who beat them this year, and it was a whale of a game. You talk about on fire. Louisville started the game hot and didn't look back. Now, on Notre Dame's side, I must tell you that they have just lost their starting point guard to a season-ending injury, and Louisville was hot. And Asia Durr took over the game early on. She is an All-American. She's playing on the USA national team, four-time player of the week for the ACC, and she leads the league in three-point shooting percentage and scoring. She is our player of the year, and she's the real deal. When you see Asia play, you will see a complete player, but a player who obviously plays well with her teammates. That's a good thing.
And we'll see those top seeds in the tournament come tomorrow. We've got a lot of basketball to play. Nora Lynn, we thank you so much for letting us be a part of your tournament. It's always a pleasure to broadcast.
I so appreciate you, Tom. I love Fox. Thank you.
You're welcome. Nora Lynn Finch, the Senior Associate Commissioner for the Atlantic Coast Conference, kind enough to join us. When we come back, Jen Hildreth, Lachina Robinson, take us through the second half of NC State and North Carolina.
The 2018 ACC Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. It's Bo time. And North Myrtle Beach Convention and Visitors Bureau. Just coast into unexpected adventures. Find special travel deals at explorenorthmyrtlebeach.com.
Second half ready to go between North Carolina and NC State. The Wolfpack leading by six after the first 20 minutes. Shot 44% in the first half, and a quick basket for Leslie in the second half.
Change to the starting lineup for the second half as Leah Church is in. Remember, Jalen Murray picked up those four first half fouls, so this is a smaller lineup for the Tar Heels.
Let's hear a little bit more about what Sylvia Hatchell might have had to say to her team. Chelsea Shine talked to Coach Hatchell. Chelsea? Get back to Chelsea in just a second. As Coonan drives, has her shot blocked by Mays. There's been a presence on both ends of the floor for NC State. Nelson can't finish. Coonan got it into Bailey. Nice move by the freshman.
Really like the aggressiveness of the freshman because Mays had her way on both ends, close to a double-double in that first half, and Janelle Bailey not afraid to challenge her.
Janelle Bailey, the ACC Rookie of the Year. 6 points in the first half. We saw her really listen to her coaches, read the game, make an adjustment in the second half of the first game of this tournament against Boston College. Baseline drive by Nelson, who's back in the game. only played 1 minute in the first half with foul trouble. And now let's go back to Chelsea Shine with that report from Coach Hatchell.
Yeah, I had a chance to talk to Coach Hatchell coming out of the timeout or out of the halftime, and she said she felt like her team needs to do a better job of rebounding. She said we're down 5 rebounds, we're losing by 6 points. That was a correlation there. She said they've also have gotten too much inside. Points in the paint was 20-2 at halftime. The first play NC State ran coming into the half, you saw another point in the paint. And then she said transition. She felt like her team needs to do a better job of getting back in transition defense.
And a lot of those transition points are added into that points in the paint. High percentage looks. You know, one thing stood out to me, though, North Carolina and NC State and North Carolina were even in that second quarter, 21-21. And it's because the Tar Heels got to the free throw line. They have to do that more.
Bailey could not get it over Mays that time. Kuden got it back. Out to Cherry for three. That is her first field goal of the game. Had 5 points in the first half, all from the free throw line. Leslie driving, got around Key.
Leslie was the leading scorer for NC State during conference play. She has really blossomed since joining this team and has been a welcome addition, especially because defensively she gives you size and length.
Transfer out of Maryland. It's 11 points in the game. Really going to work again. Get the feeling that might have been part of the conversation in the North Carolina locker room. As Chelsea pointed out, Coach Hatchell noted that deficit in paint points. Nobody better to pick those up for North Carolina than Janelle Bailey. Koenig trying to drive on Cherry. Under 10 on the shot clock. Leslie, patience to get the shot off. She is 6 already in this third quarter.
Forcing Paris Key to play defense.
Key now trying to return the favor on the other end. It's Leslie and Key again. This could be a good individual battle to watch. And Leslie went flying in to try to get the rebound. Committed the foul on her way to the basket, though. That's her third.
Kira Leslie is getting busy early and often on the offensive end, challenging Paris Key. No one steps up defensively to help. You really can't in that situation. And she has, again, size, versatility, and she hasn't shot the ball as well in ACC play as I know she would like, but is a great rebounder from the perimeter, and she can get hot.
Jump ball called, and then now keep an eye on this. Janelle Bailey and Akilah Mays, neither one wanted to let go of the ball. Does that bring up any memories from yesterday?
Yeah, it does.
It's Georgia Pinoe from Boston College and Janelle Bailey, who had a similar interaction. And Bailey just picked up a technical.
Yeah, that can be seen as taunting, because she continued to go on with the clapping, and we couldn't hear obviously if anything was being said, and kind of took the hand and put it near Mays, and the officials are trying to cut into it. See, right here, she takes that hand, and you know, those kind of gestures, and they tried to give her a warning. You see Eric, and then she starts the clapping in a moment there, and that can be seen as taunting. That's a good call by the officials to handle that right away.
Eric Bruton, Luis Gonzalez, Karen Priato are referees. And Bailey, one of those players you don't often see get flustered. We'll see how she responds to this.
Yeah, she even said yesterday in the post-game presser about the battle with Georgia Pinoe that she doesn't get rattled, but I think she kind of does. She just shows it in a different way because she's very competitive and fiery. It's not demonstrative, but it's subtle, and she's a competitor. But right there, it cost her team a couple of points.
And that was her third foul, so she has to go to the bench, and she is absolutely a huge part of this North Carolina team. Cherry. First shot goes into the hands of Emily Sullivan, who came in when Bailey went out. Wolfpack just not hanging on to the ball. Sullivan will try it again and make it.
Quality minutes from Sullivan with Jalen Murray still on the bench because of foul trouble.
Sullivan, the 6'4 sophomore out of Newburgh, Indiana. Average is just 7 minutes a game. She may see more here this afternoon, making the most of her time on the floor. Mays trying to go to work against Sullivan. Wesley couldn't finish. It snuck around Sullivan. Cherry. Morris is one up. Felt the contact from Ely. And she'll go to the free throw line.
It's going
to
take Cherry. It's going to take a cast from North Carolina offensively. You know, in that first half, Paris Key had that 21 points. And then three of the Tar Heels starters were over from the field. Now, Jamie Cherry did get to the free throw line 8 times, and that was huge.
One of the things that we told you about earlier in this game was how much NC State has used the free throw line to their advantage this season. On the season as a whole, making more free throws than their opponent attempted. That has not been the case, at least so far. These two teams pretty even in terms of both free throw makes and attempts. 11 for 13 for NC State, 11 for 14 for North Carolina.
North Carolina picking up with some pressure, trying to change the defense and momentum.
Really just stuck with it, got it to Mays. May not be how they drew it up, but they'll take it. 12 points for Mays.
Has been a lot to deal with in this game.
Kunin steps back. Cherry with the rebound. Ely tried to pick her pocket and did. How about Kayla Ely? Leads this NC State team in steals. Gets it out to Koenig. And then Key is fouled by Leslie. That is going to be the fourth on Kiera Leslie, whose work defensively has been absolutely crucial against Paris Key. So some foul trouble mounting in this battle.
The 2018 ACC Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the ACC. GEICO. New York Life. Bojangles. Food Lion. And Toyota.
55-48, our score. NC State out in front of North Carolina. This is just the first of 4 games today from the ACC Women's Basketball Tournament. As we look at our North Myrtle Beach upcoming schedule, just going to take it game by game for you here. Don't want to overload you too much. The next one coming up, 2 o'clock Eastern Time, Virginia Tech and Syracuse. Don't want to miss Tiana Mangakahia and what she does for the Orange. Just an incredible player, first team All-ACC selection who leads the nation in assists. Paris Key got a lane to the basket. Couldn't finish it off. Kick. So NC State ball.
One thing that has kept Carolina within striking distance, despite the efficient scoring by NC State in the paint, is the rebounding. We came into the game saying that was important at the break there. They were tied at 26, and Carolina's been getting a lot of second chance points here to start the third.
Mays trying to go over Bailey. Leah Church getting in there. She officially will get credited for that rebound. Church, that's a little more what we're used to seeing her do. Take the threes, can't hit that one. Amani Hawkins on the floor for the Wolfpack. Gets it over to Ely, who drives on Bailey, who just stuck a hand out and got the block.
Carolina lucky in that situation because transition defense was not ready.
Bailey bailed them out. She's playing with 3 fouls. Kunin took a ton of contact, and then nobody was there to rebound.
Shot selection is going to be important for North Carolina. They got to be willing to force NC State's defense to shift and rotate and find late openings in the shot clock if necessary.
Koenig. Your shot too strong. And then there's the rebound to Ely. Mays. Hawkins.
Hawkins. Nobody hitting at the moment. You mentioned rebounds, though, LaChina. In the two games during the regular season, NC State out-rebounded North Carolina 99-67. They were dominant. And that offensive rebound from Coonan resulted in 2 points.
Coonan, the beneficiary of the aggressive play by Bailey.
Yep. 5-point game. Healy is going to work the screen from Mays, but her shot no good. Key takes the three. She had 4 of them in the first half. Koenig, she makes it look good.
Such a fun player to watch. Aislinn Koenig can create her own shot. She's a great three-point shooter. She's one of the best in the ACC in assist-to-turnover ratio, so she takes good care of the ball and makes good decisions.
She had 18 points in the last meeting with the Tar Heels. Was 4 of 10 from 3 in that game. Key getting into the paint. Bailey got the rebound, not the putback.
With Kiara Leslie out with that foul trouble, North Carolina looking to go to Paris Key for scoring.
Nelson is fouled, and if that is on Bailey, it's her 4th. That could be big for North Carolina. So Jalen Murray had 4 fouls for North Carolina in the first half.
And this is the point of the game when you start to worry about fatigue setting in. Paris Key played 40 minutes yesterday. Jamie Cherry played 40. Taylor Coonan played 36. Janelle Bailey played 38 minutes yesterday. They look a little bit sluggish in this last stretch. And sometimes you pick up fouls just from some fatigue.
And Chelsea, you've got more on that?
Yeah, LaChina, just to add to that, these are the top 3 players in ACC in minutes played, with Jamie Cherry 38 on the season, Paris Key averaging 37.2, Taylor Coonan 35.5. And I asked Jamie Cherry that yesterday. I said, do you feel that fatigue and when you recognize how many minutes you are playing? And she said, well, yeah, but you kind of just go into every game knowing you're going to play the entire game and then just make sure you do a really good job of taking care of your body. And LaChina, I'm sure you remember in this tournament, you run off of adrenaline when you're playing multiple games in a row like this.
No doubt. And, you know, Chelsea and I talked about earlier, your body clock as a player is off. You don't play at 11 o'clock a.m. during the regular season. So there's a lot of rest, recuperation that has to happen for you to be at your best. But, you know, once the games start going, popcorn's popping, you just got to be ready to play.
Those were the first points for Paris Key in the second half. She had 21 in the first half for North Carolina. Under a minute to play in quarter number 3. NC State still leading by 7. A deep 3 from Cherry. And then NC State going so hard for the rebound, they nearly took each other out, Ely and Hawkins. What a 6-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Ely will look over at Westmore, figure out the plan of attack. Ely's drive. Church got the rebound for North Carolina, and then Nelson, who's a tremendous rebounder, came over, forced the jump ball.
Boy, North Carolina really battling to stay with NC State on the glass. Coonan exhausting herself. Leah Church has gotten in on some rebounds.
Talk about the big 3, but it's going to take a team effort from North Carolina to try to get past this Wolfpack team that has won 5 of the last 6 in the series.
Good call there by Wes Moore. I mean, you have a veteran in Chelsea Nelson being defended by Emily Sullivan, which you talked about right here, hasn't played a ton. Nelson off of the bounce, very strong to the rim.
Nelson's
Houston, a perfect 5 of 5 from the line. All of her points in this game have come from the free throw line so far, where she was limited to just that 1 minute playing time in the first half. Key will take the final shot of the quarter, comes up just short, and her team still trailing NC State by 9. The Wolfpack and Wes Moore beat this North Carolina team twice during the regular season. One more win will get them through to the quarterfinals. One quarter to go.
The 2018 ACC Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. It's Bo time. And North Myrtle Beach Convention and Visitors Bureau. Just coast into unexpected adventures. Find special travel deals at explorenorthmyrtlebeach.com.
One quarter to play in this first matchup of day two of the ACC Women's Basketball Tournament. Paris Key, 21 points in the first half for the Tar Heels, just 2 in the third quarter. But LaChina, you've got to figure, you said it at the beginning, she's going to need some help.
Yeah, it's going to take a team effort. Yesterday against Boston College, boy, BC really fought. And the change in momentum happened because other players stepped up, whether it was Coonan or Murray. Everyone did a little bit more. Nice call to start the quarter by Sylvia Hatchell, pressing her release for Paris Key.
Janelle Bailey also, to your point,
yes,
stepping up in that second half, had all of her points in the second half yesterday.
North Carolina in a triangle and two right now defensively.
Hawkins just sneaking through everybody to get the rebound and the 2 points. So many new names, new faces in big roles for this NC State team this season. It's been a storyline all season long. It's why they were picked 10th in the preseason in the conference, since they lost 4 seniors, 4 starters, over 43 points per game. And yet, here they are, tied for 4th during the regular season.
Aislinn Koenig did a fantastic job of denying Key, and here's transition defense again for North Carolina.
Yeah. It has been an issue. And NC State exploiting it there. Largest lead of the game for the Wolfpack at 11.
Koenig face guarding Key. Hawkins not allowing Church to catch it. Both teams playing some junk defense here to start. Take a look at the defense by NC State, forcing Key to have to work so hard for the ball. Koenig is not helping off. He's face guarding her. There were multiple attempts for Paris Key to try to get to the ball. NC State not allowing her to catch it.
And that's with Kiara Leslie on the bench with 4 fouls, the player who had done such a good job of slowing Paris Key down. Nelson, the glass too strong.
Mentioned again, North Carolina in that triangle and two, not letting Aislinn Koenig, and I believe Hawkins is the other player, get involved, and they're more zoned up in the middle.
Third personal on Chelsea Nelson on that play. Jalen Murray back into the game for North Carolina. She had 4 fouls in the first half and a sit in that third quarter. Key, Koenig gambled, left Paris Key open. We don't want to gamble on that too often.
Yeah, Key's got to look to get to the rim. You know, the outside shot not falling like it was earlier, but they're getting to the free throw line. Put some pressure on that NC State defense. They've got several players with multiple fouls.
Nelson just going around. One of the Tar Heel players with multiple fouls, Murray. North Carolina had it within 5 when the score was 55-50, but since it's been a 12-4 NC State run to continue to extend their largest lead of the game. It is not easy to beat the same team 3 times in the season. Anyone will tell you that. That's what NC State trying to do here, something that they have not done against North Carolina since 1990. Sylvia Hatchell, sensing her team needing some help here, calls a timeout. Does not want to let this gap continue to widen as her Tar Heels trail NC State by 13.
The 2018 ACC Women's Basketball Tournament is brought to you by Hardee's.
NC State leading North Carolina by 13. And our Hardee's stars to watch. We're not just picking one. We're picking the Wolfpack players getting it done in the paint.
Yes, 34 points in the paint of their 67 for NC State. High percentage looks equals main baskets. And what's most impressive about that is Chelsea Nelson, who is arguably their biggest inside threat, spent most of the first half on the bench. But Akilah Mays, Erica Cassell, the team really rallied and was still able to find those shots in the lane.
So Sylvia Hatchell called a timeout, trying to stop the bleeding a little bit here as NC State has continued to extend their lead. Coonan will step back and take the three. It's short. And you wonder, we talked about it early, the amount of minutes that their starters play and the fact that this North Carolina team is playing on back-to-back days, is fatigue starting to show?
Oh, and you know, credit NC State. They've done a great job, but it's hard to do this back-to-back. And I'm sure that's not the shot Sylvia Hatchell wanted. Coonan not shooting well from the outside, so they're just having inability to get the shots they want right now.
Nelson misses everything on that one. Cherry has been quiet in this ACC tournament. Next game from Greensboro coming up at 2 p.m. Eastern. Virginia Tech and Syracuse opening up their ACC tournaments as they both received first round byes. Hokies beating the Orange in the regular season. Cherry had it blocked by Koenig, who was hiding out behind her.
North Carolina had 52 points at the end of the third quarter. They have 54. They've only gotten 2 5 minutes into the fourth.
And they have struggled to score against NC State this season. Two of their lowest scoring games of the season came against the Wolfpack.
Harris Key way off on that one. You can see the frustration.
Such a strong start for Paris Key in the first half. In both of these ACC tournament games, had 20 in the first half yesterday, just 8 in the second half. But it was a win for the Tar Heels against Boston College. 21 in the first half today, just 4 so far after the halftime break.
North Carolina needs to get a punch. Bailey's a good place to go. Cherry may need to get involved on the offense, in the offensive end.
But the help defense doing its job for NC State. Bailey unable to convert, her Tar Heels still trailing. NC State trying to hang on, get this win over the Tar Heels, and get the right to play the 4 seed. The Duke Blue Devils waiting the winner of this one. 22-7 overall on the season, 11-5 in conference play. By the way, both overall and ACC records exactly the same as NC State, but because Duke beat the Wolfpack in the regular season, they got the higher seed and a little bit of extra rest in this tournament.
Yeah, that's big, and they will have to deal with the Splash Sisters if NC State is to advance. Lexi Brown has been outstanding. Player of the Year candidate, ended up Defensive Player of the Year. And when NC State first met Duke, Brown had 34 points in that game, and actually Rebecca Greenwell had 0 in their meeting, their only meeting of the season. So if the Wolfpack does advance, it'll be interesting to see how Wes Moore deals with those two.
Cherry's pass tapped by Nelson. It will stay North Carolina basketball. Tar Heels 0 for their last 9. desperately in search of some offense. Paris Key has been the go-to for the Tar Heels in this tournament. Cherry calls her own number. Nelson, such a great rebounder for NC State. Glad we get to watch her play a little bit. Just 1 minute in the first half for Chelsea Nelson after two very quick fouls sent her to the bench. Leslie back in the game. She's playing with four fouls for NC State. Key defending her and uses that sneaky little move of throwing it off of Leslie. So North Carolina ball. Just the fourth turnover by the Wolfpack in this game.
Yeah, good play here by Paris Key. Just stays in the play and is able to bounce the ball off of Leslie. But North Carolina needs a good possession. I mentioned this a minute ago. Points have been hard to come by for the Tar Heels.
Cherry driving and wanted to dish off. Teammates just not ready for it. Eighth turnover by the Tar Heels. Both teams have done a good job taking care of the basketball in this game. Leslie will take the shot. Tap the rebound out. It goes to Jamie Cherry. Tar Heel blue. She's going to take it herself this time. Good decision.
Good ball control and good focus to the finish there by Cherry, because she was going full speed and had two defenders at bay. Right here, she was just full steam ahead. Really kind of casual about getting back. Koenig never really commits, and Cherry gets to the free throw line.
You know what, LaShawna, you cannot ever count out seniors, especially when it gets to tournament time. And remember, North Carolina playing for potential postseason life, NIT bid. They need to get a win. 15-15 right now. See if they can put something together. They trail NC State by 10. Just over 3 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. NC State leading North Carolina by 10. Led by as many as 13. North Carolina's last lead came early in this game, and the score was 13-12.
NC State milking the clock here.
Cherry got her hand on the ball, still in possession for NC State. Koenig sees a shot clock winding down. Yeah, that'll do.
He looks ready to start this ACC tournament. And I think back to last year's team. And Koenig missed a significant amount of time with injury as a freshman. And you would think, you know, as a freshman, okay, well, they'll be able to fill in for what she does. I don't think that NC State really ever recovered. They did well, had a great season, lost with a chance to go to the Sweet 16 to Texas. But I just felt like when Aislinn Koenig wasn't on the floor, they weren't at their best. And she is looking healthy and really ready to take on the postseason this year.
She was one of those pieces that you knew they were just kind of waiting, as you said, to get ready to be fully healthy and proving her value this season.
And Koenig is a natural point guard, so she makes good decisions with the ball, but she can stroke it as well. That's what her reputation has been in the ACC. Just sizes up the shot and lets it fly.
Came into this game, Koenig shooting 35% from downtown, 78 made threes. She tacked on four more in this game.
Yeah, she didn't shoot well in their closing loss to Notre Dame in South Bend. And she takes that kind of thing personally. If you look at her track record, she doesn't shoot well one game. She usually comes back either the next game or two games later, and she's on fire.
One of 10 in that game against Notre Dame from three-point range. Fighting Irish, by the way, getting the number two seed in this tournament, tied for the regular season title with Louisville. Look at Jamie Cherry picking the pocket, saying, "Let me be a cherry picker." She earned it that time. 15 points for Jamie Cherry. The senior trying to keep her team in this game, give them a fighting chance. She's going to foul here.
Carolina foul by number 10, Jamie Cherry. First, second, and team foul.
been a tremendous career for Jamie Cherry. Hasn't had her highest scoring outputs in this tournament so far. And her career has just been lethal in the ACC tournament. Minute 20 as Leslie drives and is fouled.
Jamie Cherry did have a bright spot this season. She hadn't had, I believe this was her first year. She beat Duke. So that was a big win. You know, that
note those.
Yeah, for sure.
When you're a Tar Heel.
That was an amazing game. They split the series this year. They beat Duke in North Carolina. It was just an amazing game in Chapel Hill.
Nelson.
Westmore and NC State needed this from Chelsea Nelson. She got back in the game in the second half. You want her to start to get her confidence because you got some games to play in Greensboro. So let her get in, even though she missed most of that first half, and start to get her legs under her and get ready to play.
Three players went down as that free throw miss, all of them trying to get the rebound, and then good show of sportsmanship as Cherry tried to help Leslie up. Key will take the three. Bailey trying desperately to get away from Cassell and get the rebound. Couldn't quite get there.
You feel like Bailey was not really as much of a factor after she got that technical foul call.
Mm-hmm. It is a new ball game, isn't it, when you get to the ACC tournament? And even though you may not be technically qualified as a freshman anymore in the eyes of your teammates and yourself, especially with the great freshman year Bailey had, it's a different animal postseason.
Learning experience. Everything is a learning experience when you're a freshman.
Koenig getting herself open. How about that? 19 points for Ace. And NC State staring down a date with the Duke Blue Devils. Jamie Cherry may have just left the floor for the final time in her North Carolina career, the only senior on this Tar Heel team, an emotional exit.
So much class displayed. When you mention sportsmanship, always a positive attitude, a great teammate, outstanding work ethic, and some of the most exciting plays we've seen in this league during her career. Big shot. Cherry bomb.
Cherry bombs. We've seen them in this ACC tournament in some huge shots her freshman year. Buzzer beater against Louisville that sent the game to overtime as Church knocks down that three. Her sophomore year, she did it again in the ACC tournament, forced overtime against Pittsburgh, did it in the NCAA tournament. We have enjoyed the cherry bombs over the years. But this game belonged to the NC State Wolfpack. They will get their chance to exact some revenge on the Duke Blue Devils. They will meet in the first game of the quarterfinal round tomorrow. NC State, a 13-point winner over the Tar Heels. They do indeed get their third victory over North Carolina in the same season, something they had not done since 1990. So we have one matchup set for the quarterfinals tomorrow. NC State and Duke should be a great one to start off the day at 11 o'clock. Got the top four seeds getting into action tomorrow in the quarterfinals. NC State enjoying their bye and coming in here, taking care of business against the Tar Heels.
Yeah, it was really impressive for NC State. I mean, the first game is always the hardest, and they faced some adversity with the foul trouble. Things didn't go their way the entire time, but they got back to their defense. They shut down Paris Key and got major effort and contributions from Mays and company.
Well, let's hear what their head coach, Wes Moore, has to say about the win. He is with Chelsea.
Coach, this is the first time since the 1989-90 season season that NC State has beaten UNC three times in a season. When you think about how hard that is to do, to beat a team three times in a season, how proud are you of this team's effort
tonight?
Yeah,
I am. You know, I knew we were going to maybe start out a little ugly. They played yesterday, first game jitters. I'm proud of the way we bounced back. But, yeah, you know, it's 30 minutes apart. You got a rivalry there. So that adds a little to it. And then the fact, like you said, people say it's hard to beat a team three times. So just happy to move on.
The big story was Chelsea Nelson not playing much of the first half. Comes in and meets her season average, 13 points in the second half. How big is that for her confidence as you guys move forward in this tournament?
Well, it'll help her confidence, and hopefully she'll be rested, right? So we didn't wear her down today, so that's good.
Last thing for you, you held Paris Key to just 6 points in that second half and after 21 in the first. What was the biggest difference defensively?
You know, again, she's a great player. I thought Kiara Lewis did a good job for us, Gardner. And then she was in foul trouble. We put Ace on her, told her just try to deny her. But she's a great player and a tough matchup. So just got lucky, I guess.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
Westmore and the Wolfpack moving on to the quarterfinals to take on the Duke Blue Devils. We've got another game coming up before too long. We'll break that down for you after the break. Game one in the books and day two of the ACC Women's Basketball Tournament from Greensboro. The NC State Wolfpack moving on. Jen Hildreth, LaChyna Robinson. LaChyna, what impressed you about NC State in that game?
I thought what Westmore said was totally true. I mean, it's hard in your first game, you know, to get on the stage, the early start, which you're not used to, then you're facing foul trouble. So just the way they fought against the adversity and the defense they played on Paris Key was major. And then Akilah Mays, the Greensboro native, I thought she really anchored this team and gave them a calming spirit that got them settled and carried them through the rest of the game.
Such a great atmosphere in Greensboro. All the kids are getting field trips to get to come watch the games today. And those two local girls, Paris Key and Akilah Mays, putting on a show.
Yeah, really great to see. I mean, you love this early game for that reason, because all the kids get to foul in. And what was interesting is that Paris Key and Akilah Mays talked about being young kids coming to this game and watching, and now the kids are coming to watch them.
Well, let's turn our attention to the game coming up in just about an hour. Syracuse and Virginia Tech, our next matchup. Syracuse, the 8 seed, Virginia Tech, the 9 seed, but the Hokies beat the Orange in the regular season.
Yeah, it was a game where Virginia Tech really had their way. Syracuse did not shoot the ball well, but Tiana Mungakahia is a player that you will want to stand by to watch. Arguably the best point guard in the country, the way she delivers the basketball, undersized but has a big heart. But on the other end for the Hokies, Taylor Emery, an emerging star in the ACC.
Yeah, Emery had 20 points in that win for the Hokies against the Orange in the regular season. Is there a part of this game that you'll be focusing in on?
Oh, definitely. I mean, for Virginia Tech, they've got to figure out how to deal with Mungakahia. How do you slow her down? And for the Orange, it's also about hitting threes. So can Virginia Tech take that part of their game away? Those two keys are major.
Yeah, Syracuse, in case you missed it, set an ACC single game record, broke their own single game record when they hit 20 threes against North Carolina not too long ago. So yeah, when they get hot from downtown, it can be trouble.
Watch out.
So that's our next game coming up. We have four games today in day two of the ACC Women's Basketball Tournament. First game, NC State winners, 77-64. We got Syracuse, Virginia Tech coming up at 2 p.m. Eastern as they face off in our second game of this day's session at the ACC Women's Tournament. Had a good time so far for our entire crew. I'll say so long for now, and we'll see you back in Greensboro in just a bit.